girlfriend. I'll just quickly introduce myself. My name is Amartya Guha, and I was working with QSR chain for last 7 years. So my previous assignment was with Burger King, and I was leading the distribution and planning function. So coming to a topic, demand planning of limited time offer, that is very critical for today's world. And through the presentation, I just want to quickly take you through how the demand planning for a limited time offer is different from the traditional demand plan. And what are the things we can do to make it more robust, and how LTOs can actually help for any business growth. So before I move to the topic, I always believe supply chain from the traditional days when a munshi used to actually be a supply chain manager for any zamindars has moved to a procurement team, and now it is not a support function, rather it is a growth function, who is a good growth driver. So coming to the topic, what is a limited time offer? Anyone from the audience want to say what is limited time offer, why it is there in the system, why it is getting more aggressive in the marketplace? Anyone from the audience? What is a limited time offer? Yeah. Correct. So one other thing, as my friend told, converted to purchase. In last 20 years, there is a huge, huge competition between the food retail industry, maybe internationally or nationally, where people are trying to drive the customer into the restaurants or any fine dining. And in that, the customers also have a different type of choices, and they want to make it more better for them, maybe the price point, maybe the quality, maybe the taste profile, everything. So today, LTOs are various types. It can be a value addition LTO, it can be a seasonal LTO. So I was just coming from Bangalore, I was checking a restaurant where Ramadan LTO was there in a small restaurant. If you go to McDonald's is launching LTO every month through nationally. Burger King has launched around 25 to 26 LTOs in last 4 years after launch. KFC is permuting and combining different products within their regular product to make it a LTO. So LTOs are very important to make it. Actually, it has become a staple for any industry growth. And all the customers are actually trying to get something new. So LTOs are very important. Now, how LTOs are being supported by demand planning, that is very important. Now, if you see this presentation, if you see this slide, I have taken three primary samples, which I have not given the name, but the variation between the actual forecasted number and between the actual sales was 320 and 31%. When I searched the internet, I found around 18% is the market average variation between what is forecasted and what is actually sold. The reason is very simple. When the LTO is being launched, there is no historical data. Every marketing or salesperson perceive they will do very good. But ultimately, the product may be acceptable to the customer or may not work as much as they are predicting. So that is a variation between a regular MRP planning and the LTO planning. Now, in a very regular LTO, this is a product life cycle. So there is the launch phase, there is the growth phase, there is the maturity phase, and there is the decline phase. So I just want to pull it how the demand planning is very important with this product dynamic. So when there is a launch phase, now we need to visualize the supply chain, how it happened. There is a plant, there is a distribution center, and there are stores. When I talk regarding the McDonald's is having a 330 stores. These 330 stores act as a different storage space or small warehouses where one single person will be ordering the distribution center. Distribution centers will collect all the order, and they will perceive the demand planning basis the demand they are getting from the store. Stores are actually holding a lot of inventory till they sell it to the customer. Now in the initial phase, the store managers, each brand, if you take McDonald's or Burger King, they are having around 4,000 people back end. McDonald's might have 8,000 people back end where there is 17% is the activation rate per month. So these people are not a very robust demand planner, so they give a rough estimation. So in the initial phase, when the launch happens, they try to get more orders because they know there is a time and I can consume it. But actually the consumption or the sale is not so high as they are actually asking for. So that's where the first problem in the demand planning happens. because there the planner who is sitting at the warehouse or the demand planning function, he trying to understand that there is a demand, and he again put a PO to the supplier, and he built up the extra inventory which causes all the problem. Now any LTO, understand they are competing with the market, and when the LTO is launched, they are having a very limited GP, that is gross margin. So any leftover stock, or there, if there is a stock out, that will hit badly to the company. Because when the LTO is launched, there is a heavy spend on marketing, and all those money, and actually the regular product which is being sold in any channel, get less and the LTO comes up. So anything which happens wrong with the LTO will actually have a very bad P&L for the company. Now in this phase, when the launch has been done, the order tendency is very high. Only a phase where the order versus, maybe the supply versus demand. When I say supply, that is the ingredient supplies to the warehouse. And when I say demand, that is a demand of consumer of the product from the store, is only stable during the growth and maturity phase, where both are in the same hand. But in the launch phase, the order, the store ordering from the for the warehouse is very high compared to what he is selling. Similarly, in the last phase, that is decline phase, the store will order lesser than what the actually sales is happening. Because store manager at that time become very panic, very sensitive regarding the leftover inventory at the store. So that time also there is a problem, because the demand planner may go with the sale number, though the sale, the store is not promoting that promo because he knows he needs to consume all the ingredients. So that's where the problem starts. There can be a stage of revival where the marketing thing is going very good, and they need to revive with the marketing avenues and all. So that is a stage. So there is a huge mismatch with what is happening, actual sales, and what is happening, actual demand. Now we need to understand, when I am saying LTO, there is no very less reaction time. It is around 30 to 90, 60 days. And any MRP which runs, it needs a 90 day in the regular MRP process, where the logistics or production plan. So this 60 days is very, very critical, where all the demand planning need to be done in a different way. Now, it is just an overview how the restaurant industry is working. It is not only a product, there are various complexity on demand planning. So there are chiller items, there are frozen items, there are dry items. But again, we need to understand within this category, there are a lot of low shelf life products, there are high shelf life products. So those are also a minor thing which we need to take care of when we are actually doing the demand planning. Now this is a regular MRP process where sale forecasting is given, demand forecasting based on input of SOP is done, production planning is done, logistics, and this is a regular thing. But we cannot go with a regular MRP. So what we need to do, how we need to sustain. I know companies who are making loss in crores, like a wrong demand planning for the LTOs has been done. There are 3 out of 10 products where LTOs doesn't work in the market. People doesn't take all the LTOs clearly. So how we can actually sustain a good LTO if the cell number fluctuates in maybe higher or the lower? So there are some criteria. So I will just go through this one, 5 pillars through which the demand planning LTOs need to be done. One, ingredient mix. So ingredient mix, so many companies CEO will come and say, I want a tangy flavor. Give 5-6 ingredients which have a different taste profile, and we will launch and we will make it for 60 days. That is the wrong thing first that every company does. Because if you launch with 5 new ingredients, then it is very difficult to manage. So any LTO should have an ingredient which should be a balance between what you are using regularly, and also new ingredients which need to be give a taste profile. So 60% products which where the LTO should be supported should have an old ingredient, and 40% of products should be a new. It should be a mix of 60-40 or 50-50. This is the first checkpoint every company should follow, so that they can actually, if there is a problem with the entire LTO also, 60% of regular product can sustain within the system. Now the second is the duration. Many people say we will run the LTO for only 15 days. We'll have a huge TV campaign, we'll have a social media campaign, we'll run and we'll finish off in 15 days. It cannot happen. The minimum time period for the entire demand planning should be having 60 days of period. And we should know that within 60 days we'll run, maximum 90 days, because after 90 days the sales comes down. People don't have that appetite that it's the LTO anymore. It's get a regular product. Third important factor is the data transparency. So many, most of the QSR or most of the restaurant companies, some of them have their own supply chain, some of them have supply chain of the third party. So what happens when I have a third party, I see he is my my responsibility comes to third party. I have my sales projection and he will do the entire thing. Any waste over, I will put the responsibility in. At the bottom line, you need to understand third parties work with a very thin margin and ultimately they cannot sustain if their losses are huge. And we cannot also say that every responsibility should be of third party. When there are problem, when we are launching LTO or when we are doing LTO planning, it should be firstly in-house because the ownership and the monitoring should be very, 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 very minute. Now, data transference is transparency, which when I will just give you an example. So what are the data which we need to check the LTO? You will say one is sales, second you will say what is the consumption of the store. I will go two or three steps more for the LTO thing. I will give you an example. Demand planner, when I am doing a demand planning, suppose I am launching a burger which is having 10 grams of condiment, 5 grams of lettuce, 1 bun and 1 patty or 2 or 3 condiment. When this goes to the store level, there is a recipe which people says yes, this should be used by these people. And we assume they will use in the same quantity because this is an LTO I have given a training which might be for 12 hours. Practically, when this 8,000 people use this or try to make the burger, there is a variation of 25% between the what is recipe and what they are using it. And just put yourself in their position when they are preparing 800 burger per day. Are you able to give a right quantity of condiment every time to the burger? No. So that is also a important checkpoint where the supply chain guide to do how much I have supplied to the store, how much they have they are selling, and how much what was the recipe and what is the leftover and what is the cured delta. So that is a very critical part whenever I am doing a LTO demand planning because they need at least 1 to 2 months of settling time that they know how much they need to use. So that is our data transparency is not only from the point of sales but point of usage and also a point of anticipation of sales for next 2-3 weeks. Third is the inventory build and 3 hours the actual. So inventory build, when I am going with a 60-day LTO, marketing will give any data. It can give 80 burgers or 80 pizzas or 80 biryanis per day. I need to be conservative where I will not build an inventory of 60 days. I will build with the plant or the production house where I should build a 37 days of inventory if there is 60 days of promo. Why? Because within first 2 weeks, I come to know what is the anticipated sales. So I have a reaction time to give a second PO and blanket any type of turbulence in between. So that is the second point where I will use my all strategies with the plant or the vendors where I will only pick up 37 days of inventory. And within the 37 or 14 days, I will monitor my LTO very correctly, whatever number my marketing gives, so that within 14 days, I give a corrective number to the POs, correct all the back-end supplies. Any anticipated numbers which can go up or low, I can correct it there itself. And lastly, the correction of order. We can say I have got an order and store I have actually given, I have fulfilled my fill rate and I am very happy I am 99 fill rate and tomorrow if they don't give order, I will show the historical 4 weeks of order. They were giving high order, now they have slowed down. Ultimately, loss of the company, it is a loss of a company, it is not loss of anyone. So I cannot put a blame and I cannot say as supply chain, it is a marketing fault. As a company, when we need to understand the people who are working in a store or at the bottom line, they are only get paid of 12,000 to 13,000 rupees. Maybe we are giving a very good tool, they may or may not use those tools. So we, the people who are actually supply chain people in this warehouses, they need to correct the orders. First order should actually go with the auto allocation, depending on the sales of the selling point. Second order, whenever there is an order, the warehouse manager or the anyone from the supply chain team should correct it. If they are over ordering or under ordering, they should correct and supply to them. Also, the inventory at the other various point like store level or the warehouse or the plant should be monitored and there should be proper alert to the system. So these are the various steps and trust me, I was in Yum, so that time I was very fresher and had to see the demand plan. When I came to Burger King, I joined Burger King for the very first day. Last 4 years I was actually working in Burger King. And we have, it is not any derived formula which I got from books. The derived formula which we tried, experience and we found very good results. There are around 12, 13 LTOs where we have zero write-off, zero leftover. And if there is an emergency, we used to raise a flag to the people and there was a solution which we got. and that's how the companies are getting profitable. So I just want to share my experience with you guys. Hopefully you have enjoyed that. Thank you.